Spotlight Show. It is, of course, Jiggy Jag filling in this week here on KNSJ San Diego. DJA1 Audio has vanished. Don't know where he is. Oso Marlin has vanished as well. But we still got the Spotlight Show. Oh, yeah, the Spotlight Show, brother. I guess that's my little Hulk Hogan there for you. First time I'm on KNSJ in San Diego. Thank you for that. So let's go to our next guest here on the old Spotlight Show. We are going to ring the group as they do in the old Skip Skype, the old Skype-a-rooney. And we are going to see if we can get our next guests with us. And we'll see what happens here. And I believe Dan has joined us back. And I believe Texas P is on his way into the building, as they say. I don't know who's saying it. Don't know why they're saying it. But dollars to donuts. And let's hope Texas P brought the donuts. We will get it going. Yes. Texas P, how are you, sir?
I'm good, sir. How you doing? How
you doing? Pretty good, actually. You are always in a good mood whenever I see you. We have got Texas P with us today. Also, DJ Dan joins us as well.
What's up, Texas?
Hey, Dan, what's going on? How you doing, man?
I'm good, bro. I'm good.
So, welcome to KNSJ, the Spotlight Show, San Diego. Texas P, educate us. Educate the folks at home who have been sitting under a rock, or hiding under a rock, and don't know how big of a superstar you truly are.
Oh, man. I'm getting there. I'm working hard to get to the biggest that I can be as of right now. But San Diego, what's up? It's your boy, Texas P. I'm in the building. I've been doing a lot of things up and coming lately. I've been featured number 3 on European hip hop Billboard charts. Just dropped a single. No promo, went crazy all over the wire. So we working hard over here, trying to get things established, trying to get deals done and money made. That's what we're doing, you know.
Well, Texas, we've got a UK audience going on here this time. Yeah, you're going out in the UK over here. So, what I want to ask is, obviously, our radio rules are really strict over here. I don't know if you know, but we can't. If you've got clean edits or anything like that, you get them over to us and we'll get them put into the mix and the rotation here.
Yes, sir. I thought I sent them to you.
Oh, yeah. We've got them. I'll forward them over to Dan so he has them and everything. But, So Dan, one of the things about Texas P, well, I guess I'll let Texas P explain it. Tell Dan how you got discovered. This is a heck of a story.
Okay, well, kind of like, you know, your normal kind of fairy tale story. Honestly, I was at a Subway. I was rapping at a Subway. We were kind of in a guy wrote on me and gave me a car, asked me if I wanted to make an album, come see him Monday, and that ended up being my manager. And soon after that, like very shortly after that, me and my manager ended up at Ray Lewis's house while he was taping MTV Cribs. And long story short, Ray ended up hearing my music. He told me, you know, this gentleman's talented. I got to get me somewhere. A week later, I was in Studio City, Hollywood, California, recording my first 3 songs and kind of been on the ball since. So, you know,
that's mad. From Subway to a studio in Cali.
Yeah.
That's mad.
I'm Cali. It was in studio. No, we were downtown.
Just amazing.
That's one of those stories you hear when someone goes, yeah, I know someone that knows someone and knows someone that this happened. And here's the guy.
I was blessed, you know. So it was great. It was great.
Right time, right place.
A lot of great people.
Oh, good stuff. Good stuff. What's your creative process like? What sort of do you how'd you go about making your music?
I get in the studio and I go about what I feel, current events, you know, past things I've gone through, you know, if not me, then someone that's close to me. You know, I've been married now for 20 something years, so you know, I got a lot of
congratulations, bro.
That one, you know. So yeah. I try to incorporate a lot of what I'm going through and a lot of life experiences into into my music and try to make everybody relate to it as much as possible. You know, so
what always interests me is do you start off with a beat? Do you hear a beat and a melody and think, yeah, I like that beat and melody, or do you put your verse and get some lyrics down first and then try and find something for it to go to?
Honestly, what I do now, I've put myself, that's how I wrote in the past, and now how I write is I would grab a sheet of paper and I would just write. I would write, because a lot of times, you know, your beats come later. So I would just write as much as I can. And then when I finally get the song, if I have the song in the beginning, wonderful, but sometimes I don't. So I would just write how I'm feeling at the moment. No matter if it's good or bad, I would just write, and then I would edit later to make sure that it goes over the song, the way it needs to go, over the drop, and make sure that I come in on time and the way that I want it to be. So I would write and then edit. That's kind of how I do things.
Yeah, that's good.
Awesome. We've got Texas B with us today. He joins us live here on the Spotlight Show, KNSJ San Diego. Also, we are across the pond, as they say. Dan, give us the details on where people can listen to us over there in your neck of the woods.
Yeah, well, this is going to be on our drive time show, 5 to 6 p.m. prime time, Leicester 107.5 FM, and obviously on the website, www.leicester.fm. So, yeah.
So, Texas P.
We've got a few days, but we'll be on air soon.
You are always smiling, always looking like you just jumped out of GQ. How do me and Dan get on your level? or is that impossible?
Well, stop playing. You know, guys are up here, leveled up with me. It's already there. just a lot of confidence.
That's fantastic.
Whereabouts are you? Are you in Texas?
I'm actually in Pennsylvania. I stay on the East Coast. I've been up here since I was like 17, 18 years ago, and I've just been traveling back and forth to the South. But I've kind of made a living up here on the East Coast.
Cool. What's things like out there at the moment? Because we've been hearing on the news like you had a big hurricane or something.
Not us. We had the after effects of the hurricane, but, you know, the little rain and the little sogginess. But other than that, you know, right now, it's beautiful out here. I'm standing outside just kind of enjoying
looks nice. Looks nice.
All right.
We're just about to go into our sort of fall and then winter. So it's like rain for like 10 months now.
it's cold up here. You know, I'm trying to get back warm. I'm trying to get over in Cali or get over in Vegas somewhere and get warm.
Have you been out to the UK?
No, I would love to. And we're actually planning on my management, Big Hooks. We're actually trying to plan to go overseas and getting some stuff started. So that's what we're trying to work on as of now, as soon as this pandemic thing is over.
Yeah. Okay, brilliant. Well, definitely give me a shout when that happens.
Absolutely.
Seriously.
Now, your music, you cover a lot of different themes. Who are some of your musical heroes and influences?
Right now it kind of varies because, you know, music's changing all the time. So, I still stick to my Stevie Wonders. I love Biggie. I love Pac. Pac was the reason that I actually started rapping. DMX is one of the greatest performers I've ever seen. So, I mean, that's the one person that actually got me to start writing. I actually started rapping. You know, that's what made me want to build my persona up and rap with that rusky voice is when he came out. So DMX is a serious...
He's unique. He started that.
Yes. You know, so... I also play trumpet in high school. I went state in Texas for trumpet. So I also look at Miles Davis. I also look at Stevie.
Oh, man.
And so many other, you know, contributors to music, because that's what I love first is music. Music kind of is overwhelming me. I rewrite and recite music. So music is always first for me.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic.
I'm a big Miles Davis fan and Tupac. He'll get remembered as a poet, Tupac, honestly.
Oh. Absolutely.
He's like a modern day Shakespeare. When you go through his songs, lyrics for lyrics, and you read through them, there's no question. You can't even doubt it.
Phenomenal. Way before his time.
Well before his time. Even now, people still don't really get it.
Yep.
But my big rapper idol from America was Eazy-E.
Oh, man.
He was just, you know, because you don't really get those sort of real fierce guys now.
No, you gotta get credit where credit is due. And when it comes to the West Coast, gotta speak easy, you know. So Eric Wright has always been a great contributor to hip hop.
Yeah, that, yeah.
You mentioned Dre, you gotta mention Eric.
Yeah, yeah. But you guys are lucky over in America. You've got so much talent, you know. who was our guy? 21 Savage was the Brit, isn't he?
Yeah.
I believe so.
Hey, whatever works.
Whatever works. Well, let's do this. We are. I'm gonna put Texas P and Dan on hold on Skype, and we are gonna go to our spotlight mix. And when we come back, we have got more here on the
DJ
Spotlight.
DJ Audio and you on the Spotlight Mix.
I see you, man. I see you, man. Thought I did that chopper line. I see you, point. Number being cutting up. I mean nothing. From my city to your city. Cutting up, man. I see you, man.
Thought I did that chopper line. I see you, point.
Mean nothing.
All day, every day, cutting nothing up. Hit me outside, playing space, cutting nothing up. Sipping on some lemonade, cutting nothing up. With a fresh shape, cutting nothing up. Got my jeans on, bling on, bling on, clean on, bling on.
Ampliando la mente, en ese estamos, vivir la vida porque hay una sola mente, viviendo el presente.
Come on. sip, sip. You gotta hit that roll, roll back, take a trip. She look back at it. I feel like a boogie when I hit. Nah, for real though. If you try to play me, you a fool. Lil bro, hoppy, he be trying to keep us cool. They only rocking with you if they see you on the news. Jumpman 23, it's on the bottom of the shoe. Nah, shoot, real though. I live, live minute, but I'm back. Yeah. My brother with the slime, wipe his nose for the slack. I used to be a hooper, then I started writing rap. If she hear me from a droid, I won't even hit her back. Nah, for real though. And she want me for the fame. I keep in 100 in my pockets, do the same. Yeah. I hit without a rubber, I ain't know her middle name. My ex bagged on me, she done left me in the rain.
That is the Spotlight Mix, and we are back with Texas P and Dan. And so, Dan, what do you think of Texas P here? He is quite the accomplished young chap, yeah, as they would say.
He seems a great guy. He seems a great guy. I think we should get him over here to UK ASAP.
Absolutely.
You know, we need more people like him, you know, coming over from the States, because it doesn't seem to be a lot of people coming over here at the minute. But obviously, we've got everything going on with COVID. But it'd be nice to see some more artists that are breaking coming through to the UK before and breaking in the UK and going big. Because once it's normally an artist waits until they've gone really big in America, and when they're completely established, then we might hear about them. But by that time, they're too expensive, and you can't even get a ticket. Now, I know you want that. Texas P. That's the plan, yeah.
Oh, the greatest. So I would love that.
Yeah. But no, we'd like to get you, you know, it'd be great to get him out here. We're just talking when we were playing the mix there.
Yeah.
You've got three time zones in America.
Yeah.
How do you all cope with that? Is it big? Is it like an hour between each block?
Somewhat. Is it? No, somewhat. Somewhat like that. So Eastern Standard to Central, you got Eastern is Iowa, I was Pacific, I believe.
You got Pacific, you got Mountain Standard.
Yeah.
Everything, it doesn't matter where you are in the UK, it's always the same time. Do you know what I mean? You could be like really high up in Scotland or really down in the south, it's the same time. You know, you can drive across the whole of the UK in less than a day.
Oh, wow. That's technical.
Yeah. Yeah, here, if you were to do that in the United States, the time would change five times.
Yeah, I know, it's mad. And I drove down California once. It took 5 days, and that was a short journey, and that was like mad.
Right.
Scale of things over there is mad. But anyway,
to get through Texas, so I know exactly what you mean.
So what would you be doing right now if it wasn't for music? You reckon you'd still be rapping in subways or?
Something has to do with music. I'm a music enthusiast. This is what I do for a living. You know, I own recording studios. I own an entertainment company. So it definitely would be something in music. If not, you know, right now I'm opening my second studio. So I'm trying to get to a point to where, you know, we're a teaching facility. So it would definitely.
Oh, wow.
Okay. Well, what's the best advice you've been given during sort of upcoming?
Trust the process and trust in God. I could say, you know, do your homework. You know, we've talked about, you know, actually learning the business. You got to do your homework. If you don't know the business, you can't succeed in it, you know. So, you know, be consistent. Know what you're doing before you do it, and then just trust the process. Because, you know, the more you do it, the more consistent you are, the quicker it'll happen.
I've got one more for you here as well. Who would you like to do a collab with most?
That's a hard question there. That's a hard one, because I got so many artists that I would love to do work with, you know. Oh my goodness, I got so many. I would love to do a track with Nas. I would love to do a track. I would love to do a track with 50. I would love to do a track with Flo Rida. I would love to do a track with Pitbull. I would love, you know, it's so many artists out there that can bring so much difference to the genre. You know, if I can get into a studio with a great, I will, and I would absorb it all and try to bring out some good music at the same time.
Cool.
That's fantastic. Well, Texas P, before we let you go, brother.
Sir,
who walked in behind me? How do we find you online, get your stuff, buy your music, and as they like to say, give them some of your hard-earned money? Give you our money for your music?
All right. Well, I'm at all platforms, all music platforms. So Tidal, iHeartRadio, Pandora. I'm kind of everywhere. You can look me up. I'm everywhere. Texas P717 on all social media. And I'm always here, you know, always trying to crack a joke or two on social media. So look me up. Check me out.
I'll add you after this.
Yes. You are great, Texas P. I appreciate it, brother. Thanks for doing this, man.
You already know, man. Without a doubt. Nice meeting you, my man.
You too, Texas.
We are going to go to our final spotlight mix, and then we'll be back with Dan. But thanks, Texas P. Appreciate it, brother.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, man. And we are going to go to our final spotlight mix of this week. And DJ A1 Audio is off somewhere making a spotlight mix. So here we go.